Not be misogynistic. You can't degrade the woman in some way. This isn't a joke. This is serious. You tell me what turns you on, and we're gonna, and then you're going to have to do an interview about it, too. It can't be off the wall. So Stevie J came in, and we were talking it through, and I said, what do you love about women, or what do you love in your life? He said, I love two things. I love music, and I love women, like just all women. I just love women. I said, great. So Stevie came up with an idea that we would body paint women as instruments, and we would have other women playing those instruments, and that would combine the two things he loved. So we got the best body painter in the country, who, you know, painted these women as keyboards and saxophones and cellos, and then you had other women playing the, you know, with
that's
their hands
dope.
Looking like they're playing those instruments. It was a phenomenal one. Michael K. Williams, raised in the Bronx. Michael K. Williams said, I remember when I was a little boy, the women who would bring their kids to school, and then they would go home to some small apartment, and they would have a little time by themselves, very rare, and they would have these he said, I always imagined they had this fantasy life in those moments. And so Michael K. Williams' shoot looked a lot like Foxy Brown. Like, the woman was bigger. She wasn't a professional model. She had full fro. She, you know, she was just like the every woman. And it was an amazing layout. So that has given us the opportunity. Dave Navarro, for example, who is Ink Master, who's into piercing. You know, Dave, on a Saturday when he wants to relax, goes and suspends himself with meat hooks. I mean, that's what Dave does. You would think that Dave would shoot a suicide girl look, right? Tatted, pierced, tribal, you know, scarring and the whole nine yards. Nope. He shot women that were almost Victorian in their look. It was beautiful. I mean, it was insane, and it was very different than Dave, than what Dave's life is. So it's been very interesting, and it's been a very interesting vehicle to talk about what is a centerfold, because, or what is that girl? What is the epitome of that woman? Because, you know, 30 years ago, it was kind of one woman, right? It was one type. Mm-hmm. Now, maybe it is a suicide girl. That's who some people love. Maybe it is a big woman, you know, a BBW. It's a huge... That's a huge segment, you know?
Yeah.
Maybe it is the girl with the really big, big, big booty, who in other times might have been, you know, like, darling, you need to lose a few pounds. No, now that's like, that's the epitome of what's hot. Maybe it's the American Apparel, you know, lightsome girl with a really small chest, you know, that looks like she's a hippie. I mean, that's what's great, is because all of those things play. Maybe it's an older woman, I'll tell you. Happy to say this is an older woman. Our strongest genre is still MILF. It's been MILF has been the genre that's outsold everything for the last 7 or 8 years. I keep waiting for it to go off a cliff, and it doesn't. So I'm quite happy about that. But, you know, it's great that we don't have to pretend to put women or men and their desires into these little boxes and say that's all there is and that's what's right and everything else is weird. No, it's all good. It's all good. And that's really the great message is, and that's what Penthouse Letters does as well, is to say, look, if you are attracted to your girl's feet, that's not weird. That just is what it is, and it's okay, because everybody's okay with it. As long as she's okay with it, and you can communicate that to her. You know, I've got another business that I'm getting ready to start, which is like a call-in, call my intimacy coach, a coaching thing. I mean, so you're freaking out at 2 o'clock in the morning because you put on your girl's panties, and that, like, turned you on, right? When she wasn't home, you put her underwear on, and that was a turn-on for you, and now you think you're out of your mind. Well, we're here to tell you you're not. That just is what it is. And everybody needs to be able to communicate that and be okay with it. And you need to be able to have those open conversations inside your relationship and be okay with that and not live in a world of secret boxes, you know, that you're hiding because you feel like you're the only freak on the planet that thinks what you think. As long as it's consensual and as long as it's not damaging you or someone else, it's okay. You just need to be able to communicate that and be comfortable with it.
Yeah.
And even if it is that your partner says, you know what, I'm just not into that, then you need to be able to say, okay, I got it, and it's not coming in this room, okay? But I just want you to know that that is a part of me, and that's not an unhealthy part of me. That's not a part that needs to be fixed, right? I'm not broken. And I think if we, you know, we're such a crazy sexual society, we think, you know, because mm-hmm. of the media, but we're really not. We're really so hung up, and we're so uncomfortable talking openly about our desires and our sexual fantasies. Not so much in Europe. They're a little bit better with it. But here, Latin America, Asia, totally hung up on the whole thing. And it's really unhealthy because it's like it takes a whole part of us and just kind of pushes it down into this little black box and says, oh, no, we can't even think about that.
We want to remind you to please like our Facebook page if you haven't already. When you join, you'll be able to receive weekly updated news and events, live video messages, and most importantly, you'll be able to interact with tons of people just like you. So go on that button on top of your Facebook page and give it a click, or interact with us on Instagram. Without each and every one of you, Tech This Out would not exist. We couldn't do it without you. Make sure to repost and share different things you see on our page. The more you share, the better. Be sure to watch previous shows on our YouTube channel, and please subscribe so that you can be notified when we post new content. We really want to connect and hear from you, so please don't hesitate to message us.
With all this news and so much more, Mike Johns, what do they need to do, homie?
For the hottest news in tech, hands down, go to techthisoutnews.com, or you can follow us on Twitter at techthisoutnews.
Technology being on the rise has made an impact on all aspects of our daily lives as well as industries. We've seen this with the rise of Amazon, the fall of Toys R Us. From your perspective, how have brands like Pornhub, YouPorn disrupted the adult industry?
People used to ask me about how that affected Penthouse. And I would always say, you know, free porn has cannibalized free porn because there's so much of it out there. And its business model is based on selling all the traffic that rolls around that space. But that traffic has been difficult in converting. When you are somebody that logs on to free porn, chances are you're not going to want to spend money on a lot of other things. So the traffic has actually lost its value. It did not affect, and I don't want to speak for my peers, but it did not affect us that much, because if you're coming to Penthouse, you're not the guy that would go to free porn anyway. So it's two different, to some extent, it's two different markets. I mean, it's had, I think, an incremental effect on us, but not a deep effect, because we're doing something very different. It's very different content. We're also offering all the content, all the historical content from the magazine and the images, the vault content, as we call it. And we're offering more of a sort of community base in what we're doing. So it hasn't quite been the same. But it has changed the aspect of the business in this way. It has wiped out all of the smaller, not all, it's wiped out many of the smaller studios, because they were competing closer to the content that was on YouPorn and Pornhub. And it diminished or depreciated the value of everyone's content. So whereas maybe you used to do a movie for $20,000, now you can't, you know, the economics are not there. If you can't make a movie for $8,000, you're not going to stay in business. So it's deteriorated the general quality of the content that's out there, with some exceptions. But for a lot of those studios that were lower middle range studios and middle range studios, they've been driven out of business, and that's quite sad. So in that sense, it's affected the business. The positive on it is, because it has such a broad user base, I mean, there's so many millions and millions and millions and millions of people churning through that, we've actually gotten some really interesting analytical data about who watches what in what state. Mm-hmm. It's everything you can imagine. I mean, you know, Utah, big user because it's a conservative state. Mm. Big user, big fan base of interracial content is where? Where do you think it is?
What state?
Just generally, what part of the country do you think watches a ton of interracial content?
The South.
I can just tell you it's the South. It's wherever things are taboo, that's where you're going to see it, right?
Okay.
So we've had some very good, you know, one of the highest, one of the most popular genres in California for whatever reason is Asian. So it's given us some interesting user analytics, and that's been really helpful.
Wow.
What's interesting about some blockchain cryptocurrency we're involved in right now, which is Vice Token, is Vice Token has actually chosen to take on that concept of the free porn environment through the use of a utility token, the Vice Token. And what they say, or you know, what we say, I'm sponsoring it, so Penthouse is endorsing it. What we say is, look, you are sitting on a computer and you're trolling and watching free porn. Well, while you're doing that, why don't you do it inside our ecosystem? And you'll get you'll generate Vice tokens. You'll be mining Vice tokens as you're watching adult content.
Can I do
and
this, Kelly?
Yeah, you can do this. You can absolutely do this.
Wow. All right. This is, so, I mean,
and then here's what you can do. Then you take those Vice tokens. Okay, so now keep in mind, I am not a blockchain expert, but I've adopted much of the language of the blockchain, right? So that everybody talks about the ecosystem. So you have these ecosystems where Vice Token now is running around, and in that ecosystem you have, I don't know what they're up to right now, but I think they have about 10 or 12 big studios. Playboy has come on board. They're going to accept Vice Token. Some of the cam companies are going to accept Vice Token. So when you are in the Vice Token ecosystem, you watch content for free, as you would out in the old school model of Pornhub, but you're going to mine Vice Token, and then that token can be used with other content providers. So let's say you come in and you're watching, I don't know, somebody else's content, and you're mining Vice Token, but now you're going to come use it in my world, and it's going to buy a magazine subscription, it's going to buy premium Penthouse content, it's going to be the chat with Penthouse pets, it's going to be whatever other e-commerce things Penthouse has, or vice versa. You may come in and be watching some free Penthouse content and mining Vice tokens, and then you're going to go use it with one of the other studios that's inside that ecosystem. So, you know, it took me a while to wrap my brain around, and it's still not wrapped around it, believe me, but it took a while for me to really grasp what the blockchain meant, and I probably only know about 10% of it, but I like to look at it this way. This is the simple thing for my simple mind to wrap my brain around. It's like a loyalty reward program. You know, that's an easy way for me to wrap my brain around it.
Or how about this? You're like the pornographic version of Nielsen.
Yep, very much so.
Yeah.
I mean, we're already starting to get an idea of what people want to watch. For example, in the early days, because we're just in the very early day of the initial sale for Vice Token, which went really extremely well, we were asking people who bought or who signed up to reserve Vice Token, what is it you want to see inside that ecosystem? And one of the top things that they wanted to see, and this mirrors some of my broadcasters, by the way, is they want to see amateur. So that says to me, because I'm a high-end glamour brand, it says to me that I have to focus and sort of prioritize our audition tapes, for lack of a better term, our first timers, the girls that are just coming in and auditioning to see if they can get in the magazine, because that's kind of the amateur movement, right?
Sure.
So all of that is good, because look, there was a day back in the day, I think, when many brands, and certainly the big three iconic brands, and certainly one I can think of that's not me, probably thought that they were just all that and that you had to come to them, right? We are so all that that you'll just come look for us, right? That's not the world anymore. That's certainly not this world. That's not your daddy's world anymore. I mean, that was your dad's world. That's not this world. We have, you know, we have to go to you, whoever the you is that we want to participate with. And for us, it was great when, that's why we do Pop Shots. That was great when Stevie J came on board. Now we're talking to Love and